Glory, hallelujah. This is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Bethlehem, South Africa. As usual, I'm here to encourage you and to motivate you. This is the good news of Jesus Christ. Good news of God is what Jesus Christ came to give to the earth, and that is what we are preaching. And the Greek word that really translated good news really means a news that is too good to be true. And so most of the things that is in the Bible that Jesus came to do for us, when you look at them, sometimes it looks too good to be true, but yet it is true. Jesus is the word of God. Hallelujah. So today I'm going to just pray before I start the good news that I brought to you. I pray in the name of Jesus that God Almighty, you will begin to fight for this one that is hearing me. You have connected this one to hear me because you want to do something very important in the life of this one. I pray that God will make a way for you where there seems to be no way. In every area where you are receiving a no in your life, I pray that God will intervene and turn your no to yes. Everything you desire, that situations and circumstances has brought you a no, I command a change of position, a change of things, a change of status, that every no will be turned to yes, for your good and for your promotion and for your blessing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Today I want to just give a concluding part of that message which I started 2 days ago, which I titled Never Take a No for an Answer. When you look at life and you look at successful people, you will understand what I'm saying. Most successful people started with too many no's. You see, many people who are super rich today, those who are very rich, they started life in abject poverty. Most rich people were born to a very, very poor family. And they started from that ground floor of poverty. And they built their wealth. And they became one of the richest men on the face of the earth today. That life is saying no to you is not equal to God saying no to you. When things are going bad, it is not equal to the fact that God is making it to go back for you. Everything that is going wrong in your life is not from God. There is a devil that does not want it to be well with you. You need to understand this. And that is why you must never take a no for an answer. I look at history of mankind. I study some great men. For instance, Abraham Lincoln. In most of the things that he did, he was failing. He entered into politics, he failed. As a lawyer, he failed. Everything he was doing, he was failing until he contested to be the president of the United States of America. And then he succeeded. And he became one of the greatest presidents, one of the best rulers of America till date. Somebody who started life with life saying no to every proposal he made. It was like everything he did was failing. But this man continued to be dogged. Doggedness is one of the things that brings success to the man. I want to tell you this thing. I want you to consider it. Somebody said, maybe I'm not successful because I'm not destined to be successful. And I told the person, I said, well, I don't know whether you are destined to be successful or not. But one thing I know, that some people are successful because they are destined to be successful. But many, many people are successful not because they are destined to be successful, but because they are determined to be successful. I said to him, therefore, whether you are destined to be successful or you are not destined to be successful, if you are determined to be successful, you will eventually become successful in life. Stop waiting to ask yourself whether you are destined to be one thing or the other. You put your determination to be what you want to be, and determination will make you to be that you desire. Hallelujah. When you are waiting for whether you are destined to be or not, you don't know. You don't know whether you are destined to be. I don't want to know. God does not make us, he did not tell us to rule our life by destiny. Hallelujah. Destiny is unknown. But God has given you what is known. You can begin to walk from the known to the unknown. When you think you are not destined and you relax, you fail. But when you forget whether you are destined or not, you begin to work hard, you are determined to be what you desire to be, you will be that. Don't take a no for an answer. Thomas Edison never took a no for an answer, and he became successful. Hallelujah. Everyone that started life with this determination never failed. You can never fail if you are determined never to take a no for an answer. Let me tell you, life will bring a no. There will be contrary situations. There will be adverse situations. There will be situations that will be discouraging. There will be times of when you will be down. There will be times of disappointment. There will be times of failure. There will be times when there will not be money in your hand, when you will be broke. Things will happen that will pull you down. There is no doubt about it. But listen to me. When these things happen, don't take a no for an answer. When these things happen, maybe you are down, or you are broke, or something bad has happened, or you have been rejected, or an helper has dejected you, and you seem to be alone, this is the time you need to be strong. You need to be strong because you have the power to change things around. You have the power to turn things to your favor. You have the power to become whom you desire to be. All you need is to continue to be determined to do it, and you will do it. And if you've been listening to some of my messages, you are going to understand that when I talk this way, I am not saying that you have all the power, but you have a God. Hallelujah. The Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You have a God. He is living on the inside of you. You can make it. You can succeed. You can go forward. Hallelujah. You can do it. And that is why the Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 13, it says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. There is Christ in you. And that is the good news. Jesus Christ is in you. He is the hope of glory. He can do all things. Hallelujah. The God that can never fail is inside you. He lives on the inside of you. Allow him to express himself. You can make it. You will make it. Don't take a no for an answer. When life said no, you need to say yes. Hallelujah. Because God has said yes to your life. He has said yes to your proposal. And that's why you are alive. You are not alive to suffer. You are alive to succeed. Go for success. Don't settle for the failure. Go for the best. Don't settle for the second best. I see you uplifted. I see you blessed. Hallelujah. Thank you for listening. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray the power to move forward, the power to do new things, the power to break new grounds. Let it be released to this one that has heard me. In the name of Jesus, receive power to move forward. Receive power to break new grounds. Receive power to create new records. In the name of Jesus, it is done. It is well with your soul. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for listening. I want you to rebroadcast this, retweet this, send this to your Facebook friends, share this on your Facebook. You can put like on this. This is good. Thank you so much. And if you have received this by any means and you want me to be sending it to you by WhatsApp every day, then save my number. And my number is +27 74 03 02 381. That's my number. Save it now and go to your WhatsApp. WhatsApp me immediately. Say, register me. I'm going to register you and begin to send this to you every day. Because I do this every day. I've been doing it for more than 5 years. And I believe it is your turn to be blessed. Hallelujah. Amen. And I will also be praying for you every day because I pray for everyone on my prayer list. I will be praying for you every day. And God is going to do a new thing in your life. Thank you for listening. And I'd like you to be a partner with us, financial partner. On our, if you got this on our website, you just see on the right-hand side, our PayPal button. You can pay with your credit card or your PayPal account. And any money you pay to this ministry, we are using it to spread the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ so that more people can hear this good news. Hallelujah. Thank you for listening. I really do appreciate you. The Lord bless you and increase you in Jesus' name. This is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Bethlehem, South Africa, signing out and saying, be blessed and remain blessed.